Hello dear friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni. Welcomes to my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to teach you write operation on files in C file handling. For today's session, the agenda is, or the topics which I am going to cover are: creation of new file, which is already explained by me in my previous video. For your reference, the right up corner I am going to flash the shortcut for the same video. You can go through that and return back to current video to go forward for write operation. So creation of new file I have already explained in my previous video. Now next topic will be opening an existing file and closing a file. Both the concepts also included in that video, but they are important as far as the write operation is concerned. That's why I am going to explain both these topics in short in my this current video. So opening an existing file and closing a file, that I am going to take a glance for the both the topics. Then I am going to cover the main concept is nothing but writing into the file. So writing to the file, I am going to cover how to write a single character to the file, how to write a string to the file, how to write a formatted string to the file. What do you mean by formatted string and how to write it, that I'll explain. Then how to write a structure record or a record of a structure to the specifically binary file. So I am going to cover these four points mainly in my video. The next thing, how to read data from a file, that I am going to cover in next video. And how to move to the specific location, this also I am going to cover in next video. Specifically the seeking operation I am going to cover in next video. For these video, please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Now let's start with the opening and closing file and its overview. So mainly we need to use the file structure and its file pointer. We need to use this file pointer is used to point to the file. This fopen function is used to open the file name, whatever we have mentioned over here, in the specified operating mode. Here I have mentioned that the file we are going to open will be the text file, file.txt, and the opening mode is nothing but the write mode. After successful opening of a file, this fopen function returns the base address of that file in this fp file pointer. And after unsuccessful opening a file due to many of the reasons that all are explained in my previous video. So after unsuccessful opening of a file, this fopen function returns the null value. So we are going to check whether the file is successfully open or not by comparing the content of fp with null. If they are equal, it indicates that error in opening file and we are returning from this position itself. Otherwise, whatever the next operation we want to perform, that we can perform on the open file. Now here I am just going to explain how to open file and how to close file. That's why I am writing this open and close functions over here. So with the help of this fclose function, I am going to close the file. For this I need to pass this fp file pointer. That means which file we want to close now, that file pointer we need to pass over here. So this is nothing but the brief introduction about how to open a file and how to close a file. Now next we'll start with the writing operation onto the file. So now let's start with the writing single character to the file. How to write a single character to the file? If I want to write a single character, what I need to do? So basically the function use to write a single character to the file is fputc function. To this fputc function, the two parameters we need to pass. the character variable and a file string on which, or a file pointer on which we are going to write a character. So now this function writes a single character to specify a file at a file pointer position, and it returns the same character if it is successful. Now what we need to do next thing is, this is nothing but the this character, whatever we are going to pass is nothing but its integer promotion. You can see over here is nothing but the data type of this variable is nothing but integer, but we are trying to write down the character variable, so that's why this is called as, this is nothing but the integer promotion. But the variable that we are going to write down over here will be of type character, that we are going to write down a character onto the file. After this, after writing a character to a file, file pointer points to the next position, means it will get incremented by its own into the same file. Now at the end of the file, or the if it is the end of file and it is not able to write that character onto the file, it returns the end of file EOF character. It returns, EOF stands for end of file character, so it returns the end of file character if the end of file pointer is there or the error occurred while writing the single character onto the file. Now we'll see one example for the same. Now here, let's see, here I have declared a ch variable of type character and I am going to assign a to that character. Here I am opening a file in write mode. I am going to check whether the file is open successfully in write mode or not. Other way around, we can say that file is created or not, as I am going to use a w mode over here. If the content of fp are equal to null, it indicates that error while opening a file and it will return back from the main function, or it stops its execution. But if it is not, if the file opens successfully, then here we are trying to write down the character a onto the file with the help of fputc function. So my first parameter is nothing but the character which I want to write onto the file, and on which file, that file string pointer I need to pass as a second parameter. So this function is nothing but used for the writing of single character at a time. So this will write a single character at a time. If you want to write the multiple characters, that many times you need to call this function fputc to write the multiple characters onto the file. At the end, after performing the operation, I can close my file. So with the help of fclose fp function, I am going to close my file, and here I am going to close the main function successfully. So all these things are about how to write a single character onto the file. You can pause this video, you can write down this code, and you can try to execute this code. You will get that the file is created in w mode. After that, you are writing this a character onto the file. You can reopen the file and you can check whether that A is written in file or not. Now we'll go forward for the string. That is, if the multiple characters I want to write down, for that I can use the fputc function. But that many times I need to write down that how many characters I want to write down. Instead of, if the set of characters are there, is nothing but a string is there, what I need to use for the writing a string onto the file. For this, the function is used is nothing but fputs function, where for this fputs function we need to pass again two parameters. The first one is a base address of a character string, and the second one is again a file pointer in which we are trying to write down a string. This function, what will do, this function writes a string to the file at the specified pointer location. So wherever now currently the file pointer is pointing, at this location the string will get write onto the file. What it will return back, So it will return the same string after successful writing a string onto the file. And in case of error, just same as of fputc function, it also returns the end of file character, EOF character, if the error is occurred. Now let's see one example of the same, how to write a string onto the file. So here I am going to create a file pointer over here. I am going to declare the string of the size 100. Next, I am going to open a file of the name file.txt in write mode. Other way around, we can say that we are going to create a file. After successful opening, this FP pointer will be having the base address of a file. This logic I am just going to use to check whether the file is successfully open or not. If it is not null, it means it successfully open and we can perform the write operation onto the file. This str variable, that is character, set of characters, I am going to assign a statement. This statement is to write on the file. I am going to assign this statement to the string variable, character array variable, and I am trying to put that or to write this string onto the file. Instead of this, you can accept a string from a user and you can put that string as well. Here I am going to put this string onto the file pointer, associated file pointer. File pointer is currently associated with the file.txt file. So I am trying to write this statement is to write onto the file, onto the file.txt. After writing this statement, if the it is successful to write a string, it returns back the same string, and we need to close our file after successful writing the string onto the file. So with this fclose fp, it will close my file. And here this was the example of how to write a string onto the file. Next we will see how to write the formatted string onto the file. Now first of all, what do you mean by formatted string? Now let's see what the function we can use to write the formatted string. I'll explain what do you mean by formatted string as a next point, but now first of all let's see how or which function we can use to write down the formatted string. For this, the fprintf function is used, where we need to pass a first parameter as a file pointer parameter and the next parameter as a constant character with its format. So now what this function will do? This function writes the formatted string to the file, just same as of input output console. So other way around, I can say that just same as of the printf function, the fprintf function will work. I'll explain all these things with the help of example. Now what this will do? This write function, fprintf function, will write data to file just same as of fprintf. I'm very sorry, this is a printf function instead of I have written the scanf. Please read it as a printf function. And one extra parameter, like a file pointer, we need to pass to write data to the specified file. That is nothing but a file pointer as a first parameter. So now let's see one example with which you will be clear with the fprintf function. Here I am going to use my first string as the str1, or first we can say that parameter str1 is nothing but the set of characters, where I am going to assign a value welcome to this str1. The next variable is of type integer, and I am going to assign 2018 to this variable year. Now here I am going to declare the FP file pointer with which we are trying to create a file.txt file. As I am going to open it in W mode, it will get created as a blank file. Open file in write mode. Now again, this is the logic which is used to check whether the file is open or created successfully or not. Now let's consider our file is created successfully. Now here we are trying to write the formatted string to the file. For this I have written a function fprintf over here. As of I explained previously, this first parameter will be a file pointer, associated file pointer, on which we are trying to write down the formatted string. For which the next thing will be just same as of our printf function, where this is nothing but the format we are going to declare. Key with the first parameter will be of type character string, second parameter will be of type integer. So this format is going to be explained that the first variable will be of type character string, the second variable will be of type integer. Both I have declared over here, both I have initialized over here, and the both things I am trying to write down at a time, that is one string and one integer value at a time onto the file. So this is nothing but the formatted string. The data of the different types of data which you want to, or which you are trying to write down onto the file, this you can do with the help of this fprintf function. Just same as of here printf function. The printf function used to print the data onto the console. Here fprintf function is used to data, or used to write a data onto the associated file. The rest of things are same. And after successful writing this content onto the file, we are closing our file. And this also you can execute a code. You can pause this video, try execute it on your machine, and let's check whether these both the things welcome 2018 is written on your file or not. Next we'll go forward for the how to write a record or a record of structure to the binary file. So whatever we have done till now are nothing but the things we have done with the text file. And now for a binary file, what I am going to explain now for a binary file. So now let's see how to write structure record onto the binary file. For this the function used is nothing but fwrite function. Fwrite function, where four parameters we need to pass. The first one is address of data. Second one is size of data. The third one is how many numbers of data you are trying to write down onto the file. And the last one is pointer to the file, that is file pointer. So now this function writes a structure record onto the binary file specifically. You can use this binary, you can use the same function for the text file as well. For this we need to provide the address of structure variable, the its size, then the number of records, and last one is file pointer. I'd like to explain the example for the same. Here I need to declare a structure over here. I'm going to declare a structure of student with two variables, or two members only. The first one is nothing but its roll number. The second one is nothing but the set of characters having the variable name of student. After that, for n number of students I am trying to write down a record, so that's why I have declared n over here. A single variable of structure student I am going to declare it as s, and a file pointer of a type structure file. Here I am trying to open this is one example where with which we can check whether the file is created or not. If it is equal to null, that is the file pointer, whatever, after opening a file in WB mode, here I need to take this WB mode, because all these things we are trying to open, or we are trying to perform with a binary file. That's why WB mode. And here again the extension is nothing but the binary. Here you can use the .dat extension as well. If it is equal to null, it indicates that error while opening a file, and it will return back from a function. But if it is not equal to null, it will go forward for the rest of execution of our program. So now let's consider I am trying to write down 5 records where they will start from n equal to 0, n is less than 5 and n plus plus. I'll accept I'll accept the things from the console, that is the roll number and a name of a student S from a user. That's why ampersand S dot roll and S dot name. So whatever data is available with our S variable means it will be having its roll number and name that I am trying to write down onto the file. So that's why the function I have used is nothing but F write function. The first parameter was the address of a structure type variable, so that's why the first parameter I am going to pass as the address of the variable S. Second one, how many bytes you are trying to write down, that is nothing but the size of data. For this I am going to use this size of operator. This size of operator will calculate the size required for this user defined data type structure student. How many records you are trying to write down at a time, for this the number of data I am going to use this as a third parameter. I am going to write down a single record at a time, so that's why one I have written as a third parameter. And now the last parameter is nothing but the associated file pointer on which you are trying to write down the data. So with these, what we are going to do, so whatever the data is available with the variable S, that we are trying to write down onto the file with the help of F write function. After successful writing this data onto the file, we are closing our file over here and we are stop the execution. Again, you can pause this video and you can check whether the program is giving correct output or not. Keep in mind, this for loop is going to be executed for 5 times. For 5 separate students, we are going to accept a value at a time, one student, and at a time one student, or the information of one student that we are trying to write down onto the file. Okay, internally this fwrite function is going to be incremented to the next position after writing this size of data onto the file. After writing this size of data, after successful writing this size of data, the file pointer will get processed to the next position by its own, and in this way we can write down n number of records onto the file. I would like to compare all the functions with these different parameters. So what will be our requirement? According to our requirement, we are going to choose the function which we can use for writing data to the file. For every function, what will be the syntax, how many number of parameters and which are those we are going to pass to the function, what will be the return value after success and after fail, and what will be its example. In this way, I am trying to explain all the 4 operations or all the 4 functions that I have explained just now in the previous few slides. So this is nothing but the recalling of all the functions, you can say that. So first of all, how to write a single character, or to write a single character, fputc function is used. What will be its syntax, that I have mentioned over here. The number of parameters are nothing but 2. The first parameter is nothing but the character which we are trying to write down, and the second one is nothing but a file pointer. So what will be its return value? On a successful writing a single character, it returns the same character from the file. And on fail, it will return the end of file character. And what will be the syntax? For this, the 2 parameters I have passed, that is ch and the file pointer. To write a string onto the file, fputs I am going to use. The syntax is nothing but, the first is nothing but the constant character, the address of constant character string, and second one is nothing but the file pointer. The same I have explained over here, 2 parameters. The first one is nothing but the base address and the base address of a string, and the next one is nothing but a file pointer. After successful writing a string onto the file, the same string is going to be returned back from a function, or on a fail due to any of the reason, it returns the end of file. And the example is fputs, the string variable, and a file pointer. rest of two functions are, if I want to write down the formatted string onto the file, that is nothing but the different variables of different data types. If I want to write down onto the file, for this I'll use the fprintf function. For the fprintf function, the syntax will be like this. The two parameters we are going to pass, the first one is a file pointer and the second one is formatted string. On a successful, it will return back the number of characters written onto the file, and that will be obviously a positive number. And on fail, it will return back some negative number to indicate that the writing onto the file is unsuccessful. For the example, I have explained that if I want to write down a roll number and a name of a student, now this is not a structure type variable, this is general two variables, roll number and name. For this, I am going to use the %d and %s respectively, but my first pointer will be a file pointer, associated file pointer. So in this way, we can use this fprintf function. I would like to explain one more thing, is like, if I want to write down the structure of a record of any structure onto the file or onto the text file, for this we can use this fprintf function. And the last one is to write a record specifically or specially in the case of binary files, we are going to use fwrite function. This one is nothing but a syntax for the same. The number of parameters are four parameters we are trying to pass to the function. The first one is address of structure, second one is size, third one is number of records, and the last one is a file pointer. On a successful writing a record, number of records whichever return onto the file, it returns that number, and on fail, it returns the end of file. And this is nothing but the example of fwrite function, where the first one is address of structure variable s, then the second one is size of the structure, how many records you are trying to write is nothing but one in this case, and a associated file pointer. So with these two slides, this slide and this previous slide, I am trying to summarize the content of my today's session. So thank you, dear friends. If you like the content and my video, please do not forget to give the comment. I would like to explain you, or I would like to give you suggestion, like, if you like the content and the video, please like the video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks, and share it with your friends. Again, don't keep your bell off, because the ringing bell will give you the notification or updates of my channel. Thank you.